Hi guys, we are here to meet the Transport Minister, Mr. Nitin Gadkari from Central Government. And you know about him, obviously, and he has, you know, been very active in promoting electric vehicles. He has graciously agreed to give us a brief interview, and we'll talk to him about electric vehicles and his vision for electric vehicles as well as overall mobility.
A lot of things. And we really appreciate this opportunity to meet with you today and talk to you about electric vehicles. So, you know, just to show you real quickly, this is a
your system is fast charging stations.
There are fast charging stations.
We having the latest technology for right. Fast charging.
Right.
What is the time for charging for bus?
I guess it will depend on the battery of bus. We have the biggest charger, 120 kilowatts per hour. So, you know, probably like two and a half hours at.
We have to cut the time.
Right. Yes. Yes.
Nagpur, we have 20 charging stations.
We have heard about that and we are really impressed about that. So that is fantastic. We have YouTube channel. We run almost half a million users every month visit our channel. So we are, you know, very popular there. Our users would really love to know, you know, to get firsthand, like, what is your vision going forward, like next 5 to 10 years? You have talked in the press as well, but it would be great to hear from you firsthand.
We are facing economic crisis because of oil import.
Absolutely.
At the same time, because of huge oil import, we are facing problem of pollution.
Correct.
So the country needs the policy, import substitute, cost effective, pollution free and indigenous.
Right.
And that is the reason that our government decided to giving highest priority for alternative fuel. Mm-hmm. Electric is the option. We are now coal surplus and electric surplus. And really, it is a remarkable thing for the social, particularly the social point of view. It is going to create more employment potential. The pollution is a big concern because of diesel and petrol.
Right.
So the government has decided to give alternative of ethanol, mm-hmm. methanol, biodiesel, bio-CNG and electric.
Okay.
Electrics, as today it is already, we have now electric bike, electric auto rickshaw and electric car and electric bus. In just 15 days before, Pune Corporation has floated a tender for purchasing of 150 electric buses.
Yes.
In Mumbai already we have electric buses.
Right. Yes.
In Nagpur we have 35 buses from Scania, air conditioned buses running on bioethanol.
Right.
Now our department has taken a decision mm-hmm. to start pilot project in Mumbai, Pune and Guwahati, where we are running buses on methanol, methanol from coal. In Mumbai the RCF and Gujarat Fertilizer, Deepak Fertilizer, they are already manufacturing methanol. At the same time in Guwahati, the Assam Petroleum have a capacity of making ethanol, methanol, 100 ton per day. Now they want to export methanol from Guwahati to Bangladesh. So we have decided to giving priority for pilot project in Guwahati, Pune and Mumbai and New Mumbai, where 10 buses we are going to launch using methanol.
Okay.
Methanol is 22 rupees liter and diesel is more than 65 rupees per liter.
Right.
Ethanol is 52 rupees per liter. But at the same time, conversion of waste into wealth is equally important. Mm-hmm. In Ganga, in my own ministry, we have 150 biodigester. That from biodigester, we can get methane. And by bifurcate methane from CO2, we get bio-CNG and we can run the buses on that. Even from cotton straw, wheat straw, rice straw, bagasse, we can make ethanol. Mm. That is second generation ethanol.
Okay.
We can make ethanol from molasses, then B-heavy molasses, then from corn and now municipal waste. So conversion of waste into wealth is the future for the country.
Right.
And we definitely, there is a huge potential. The economic viability is there in solid waste management and liquid waste management. My feeling is the country has got the potential of 5 lakh crores of economy for solid waste and liquid waste. Now the solar energy is available, wind power is available.
Yes.
There is no problem as power is concerned.
Right.
It is import substitute, cost effective and pollution free. So electric bike, electric auto rickshaw, electric bus and electric car are really the future for the country.
Absolutely.
Now 85 rupees of petrol, 65 rupees of diesel, 52 rupees of ethanol equal to 10 rupees of electricity. It is very cost effective and pollution free.
Right.
At the same time, our government has taken a decision to give a priority for public transport on electricity.
Okay.
The ropeway, cable car, funicular railway in the hill area.
Yes.
That is also going to help to the environment of this country. At the same time, we have to save the import.
Right.
And at the same time, the pollution is a big concern.
Absolutely.
So now we are also planning for future, making of electric highway. We are making highway from Delhi to Mumbai, which is going to reduce the distance by 120 kilometer. We have started works more than 44,000 crore from Mumbai to Vadodara. Next month, we will start from Mumbai to Delhi to Jaipur. And it is a new green alignment. So I am trying for that, still it's not confirmed, that to make an electric highway by which we can take our trucks on electric.
Okay.
So electric is an alternative for us.
Right.
Methanol is from coal. From methanol, we can make DME, that is gas.
Right.
And USA, they are adding 20% DME in LPG. We can reduce the cost of cylinder, the gas cylinder which people are using, by 100 rupees per cylinder. At the same time, it is import substitute, cost effective and pollution free. And at the same time, indigenous, creating employment potential in the country.
Right.
We are working on diversification of agriculture towards energy and power sector. Today, we have taken a lot of decisions, and I feel that the day will come. There will be no import. We are going to increase our own capacity of production for crude oil.
Okay.
By which present it is 30-70, 30% indigenous, 70% import. But we'll go to get 50% production from the country and 50% from biofuel, ethanol, methanol, biodiesel, bio-CNG and electric. I feel that it is the future. It is the cost-effective, pollution-free. So people are taking it. It don't need any program. It don't need any plan.
Right.
When it is cheaper, pollution-free, cost-effective, people are going to purchase it.
Yes.
So now the Bajaj, the TVS, all companies, the Hero Honda also, they are now manufacturing electric bikes. And we have taken a very good decision that electric auto rickshaw or biofuel auto rickshaw, bike and bus will be free from permittance. They don't need license.
Okay.
So also now I'm planning for starting of two-wheeler as a taxi, like Ola and Uber.
That will be fantastic.
There will be electric meter, electronic meter, by which in the rural area, small towns, people will call him. He will go to their house and he will take them with the helmet and taking it to the station and airport. So it can be creating more employment potential to the rural and agriculture sector.
Can it be done in Mumbai? Because we would love to.
No, we will not allow this in Mumbai because it will not be appropriate to allow two-wheeler bike or as a taxi in Mumbai.
Okay.
Because some of the areas also ban auto rickshaw. But like cities, second standard to two-tier cities, three-tier cities, in the rural area, the district places, the Nagar Parishad level, where we can do it.
I see. Okay, okay. Great. And you just mentioned about this whole array of fuels. So we had, there was discussion about by 2030, all vehicles being electric. So now is that
so I the don't think this point? Is not the proper thing which people are unnecessarily discussing.
Okay.
I just asking you an example. You have a petrol car. Your bill is 6,000 rupees. Suppose the same price, your bill come to 1,000 rupees.
Right.
You are going to purchase electric car.
Yes.
It don't need any market and plan for that.
That's
even
true.
Even not for subsidy.
That's true.
Because the GST on petrol and diesel car, SUV is 48% and electric and biofuel is 12%.
Oh, okay, okay. So that reduces the capital cost as
people
well.
People are going to take it.
I see, okay, okay.
They don't have option. They have to save the money.
Right.
Save the pollution. It's a natural choice available in the market. You don't need to make any plan for that.
Right, right. Very true.
Because the economics is there.
Yes.
By purchasing electric auto rickshaw, the income of auto rickshaw owner will be increased by two times.
Right. And you know, so now another question sometimes people feel about is like, how is that fitting into Make in India or being self-reliant? Like, we still don't have a plan that actually manufactures battery cells. So is there a vision to...
There is a problem for lithium-ion battery.
Lithium-ion battery.
The ISRO have invented the technology. And just 8 days before I have a meeting with the director, he was telling me that 20 Indian companies purchased that technology. Now, in the whole world, the battery charging system, the lithium-ion battery, every day there are a lot of changes. The new production is start. So when the number is more, price will be less.
Right.
Today, day by day, the cost of the lithium-ion battery is reduced. But still, India needs to manufacture the lithium-ion battery in the country. That is the need of the hour. Because it should be indigenous, it will really be a great thing for the country. Thank you.
Fantastic. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we had a really good chat, a good interview with Minister Nitin Gadkari. We were really impressed with his command over facts and his knowledge, of all the costs and economics involved. But definitely, it's going to be in the direction of environmentally friendly fuels, and reducing the import also seems to be a priority. Another thing that sort of we noticed was previously the policies were also designed with this objective in mind, that moving to electric vehicles. So subsidies and drive demand that way. But now the policies seem to be designed with keeping multiple objectives in mind, like job creation, steady transition with the industry. So the policies are going to be more like subtle change that support the economics and eventually catalyze this transition. So it was a great chat, and we came out with some really good information, and we'll definitely keep an eye on things as they evolve. So what do you think? Do you think this is the right direction for the government, for the industry? Please share your thoughts in the comment section below. We would love to hear from you.